Hello everyone. I hope you guys are not feeling Monday blues and having a good day. So today is Monday and I thought I'll start a new series from today. I've been thinking a lot about what the series should be. I first thought maybe I'll make it on array or strings, but then I thought that this is one of the most important prerequisite, and usually when I start my preparation journey or even if I'm revising, this is the first step that I do, is to brush up the STL concepts. Or if you are not aware of what STL is, then try to learn it. So just give a couple of minutes and decide for yourself if this series is for you. So if the series is not for you, you can probably stop watching. But if you feel that whatever reasons I am giving you and you should follow this, then I am going to promise you that in next 1 week, it's going to be the most amazing start for you guys. So yeah, who is this series for? If you use C++ as your primary coding language for interviews, then this series is definitely for you, because C++ STL library is the most popular library and most easiest library to use. You can do many complex tasks using this library. For example, are you scared of using heap sort? Are you scared of using stacks and queues? Everything is there. You just need to call the functions. You just need to know how to call and how to use this library. So, if you want to start your coding placement preparation, but, at seeing just the sight of difficulty of questions, you don't find the courage, then this series is definitely for you. I am going to make at least 10 to 15 videos that will clearly explain you STL. And if you're not doing any coding preparation, but you want to start with your competitive coding journey, then this series is for you. Because, even if you are like coding in Java or Python in competitive, at some point you will have to switch to C++ because of the performance, fast performance. And this library comes in pretty handy. So if you try to see the code of any of the top coders, top rated coders in any of the coding platforms, you will find that they use C++, and one of the major reasons why people use C++ is because of the STL library. So if you feel that this can be something that adds value to you, or this is something you want to learn, you can watch the entire video. If not, you can probably drop off, and whenever I post a series that is for you, you can probably watch it. Okay. Great. If you're still there, that means you're interested. So what will you get out of this series? I will talk about the full STL library, how the containers work, how the functions work, how the iterators work, what algorithm STL provide. So even if you need to sort just one line code and the array is sorted, even if you want to find the HCF of two variables, you don't need to write the entire code. That is pretty amazing, right? So don't worry if you are just overwhelmed by looking, what the containers are, what the iterators are. I am going to start with the basic and make you an expert. So what will you get after learning all the concepts? I will choose at least 5 to 6 questions that are purely based on STL that are otherwise very difficult to solve and live coded with you. Yes, you heard it right. I'm not going to pre-record it. I will live code it with you, all the things, and you can probably code it with me. So this series is supposed to have 10 to 15 videos, including the lectures and the live coding sessions. And I am planning to cover it in a week or two. So mostly I'm planning to have the live sessions on the weekend, so you can watch live and watch it with me, code it with me. After the series is done, you will have a strong base to get started with actual questions. So if you want to start your preparation journey, I will highly recommend that you don't miss your sessions. And whenever there is a, hit that bell icon, and whenever there is a new upload, just watch it with me. Because, even if I know these concepts, again, if I have to start preparing or solve some questions, I need to use these, I need to brush up these concepts. So that's why I thought probably I'll make this post. And recently I interviewed for GS, most of the questions that I was asked were solved via STL. Otherwise, for example, if you are given a heap question. It is very difficult to implement a heap from scratch, but if you're using STL, you know, it's very easy to use the inbuilt containers and do it. So I challenge you to make this week a productive one. The video's length won't be more than 15 minutes, so I challenge you to take 15-20 minutes out of your day and get started with this. It will boost your confidence, and if you're scared to get started to solve those questions, I promise you will make it easier for you. So hit that thumbs up button, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and I'm pretty excited for this series, and you should be too. Share it with people who are scared, who are looking to start. This will give you an edge. Thank you guys. Bye bye. Have a nice day.